Okay, Katrina, a couple things I'm going to show you to help you with future blog stuff. So when you look at this, you'll see that, let me scroll down a bit because I already did some corrections. So you really don't need to put this in the subheading every time. I did it one other time. Yes, it wants them in the subheading, but if you put it there every time, it becomes hard to read. Now, the reason why the subheadings look a little weird is when you look at the text here, however they transferred in, it didn't just bring the text, it brought all this other data with it. So when you brought the stuff over, it brought not just the words, but everything else, which means it's sitting strange. When you get rid of all that in there, you'll see that it then comes out cleaner and gets you more of what you're looking for. And then the other thing I would do is we're going to actually take this and copy it, and we're going to use that text as a subheading. We're going to actually make it an H3. Okay, Katrina, as you can see, this is the fourth page of the COSMarketingAgency pages. Optimization is complete. I have gone through all of them and not just added the alt text to images. In a couple cases, I had to add the keywords and the optimization. There are a couple here which you should be aware the phrasing and such doesn't match. Like a good example here is social media consulting. Inside and the URL both don't make mention of social media coaching, social media consulting company. But when you look at this and your keyword phrase thus is social media consulting, but a lot of your interior material talks not about consulting, but coaching. And really that, you know, this should be social media. If this was consulting instead of coaching, it would match better when it comes to your SEO here.